women? Are you seeing any kind of complications from toxoplasmosis? What has your experience been with your patients?
Yeah, so it's a question I ask all my pregnant patients at that first visit. Do you have any cats? So it is something that comes up. So if they do have cats, I do advise all my pregnant patients that they are not to change the litter box. That's something for the other people in the household. They're off the hook. If they have to, we say to use gloves, but better to just try and stay away and to be as safe as you possibly can.
Yeah, that makes good sense. Have somebody else do it. And again, doctor, it's because, as you said, don't touch the litter box. It's the feline feces that are actually the problem, right? It's coming in contact with skin, or again, what is it about the feline feces that can lead to this problem?
Right, so it's if you were to actually ingest it, you get it on your hands to your mouth, so you wear gloves, you wouldn't want to actually ingest it. So this is where you need to be careful. Just anything you can be the safest is what we recommend.
Okay, and you know, doctor, this is such an unusual or kind of a rare, again, infection. I mean, is this something that came about by how? Is it one woman just had this problem and it went from there? I mean, as far as the background goes, how did we even know that this could be an issue?
Right. Well, I mean, just like any abnormality that has happened to a baby or a person, is they find out that that's what the cause is. But toxoplasmosis, they also have it in undercooked meat. That's right. A recommendation I make to all my patients. You have to be careful. You don't want to be eating that very rare meat. Also, when you work in the garden, in that soil, if that could be contaminated, also, you really need to be careful with that hand washing. Very, very important.